welcome back to Wonderland, Sphinxers and Laytonites. Today we'll be playing one of my favorite games on Steam, Bokida, Heartfelt Reunion. Or is it Bokida? I'm not sure, I just know it's Korean, because it's made by a Korean studio, Rice Cooker Republic. But I'm sure someone will correct me in the comments. So I've played this previously, so this will be kind of more of a walkthrough. I really recommend that you pick it up on Steam, especially if it's on sale, which I think it is right now. From what I played, I believe it's like a love story between two planets, and we kind of act as the interplanetary wingman, so that they can do the interplanetary hippity-dippity. So with that said, let's get it on. I think that about sums it up. Do you remember the warmth of our embrace? Do you? This perfect union which we were suddenly denied. Yeah, this game is mostly just black and white, but still pretty as the day is long, so don't you worry about that. From this distance, your body's power over mine is almost imperceptibly dim. See, isn't this pretty? But if you could only see yourself as I see you now. A bright star bathed in gentle light. Pretty sure that this is the light planet that's speaking. She, he be thirsty, I tell ya. Someone should introduce her to Mars so that she can get a drink of water. Haven't we drifted long enough among the nebulae, from the fair dawn to the melancholy dusk? Oh, but I think this is where things get a little raunchy. Oh. Not sure if we'll have to censor this. Can you hear the resounding reminder of our past embraces? And boom goes the dynamite. Can you feel as I do the impetus of our reunion? Someone text that to your ex. Like, can you feel the resounding reminder of our past embraces? See what happens. My body is propelled through the heavens. All my senses waking. Including smell of vision. May a messenger heed my call. May it guide me to you. Prologue. Rain starts. I know that you are probably illiterate, but gotta fill that blanks, that dead air time somehow. Messenger, awaken. You're destined to bring about my return. Now I wonder if this is the dark planet talking, but okay, so here we are. We play as the messenger. Delivering the booty call to the dark planet. Don't ask me why I've been thinking about this, but how would planetary coitus work? I kind of imagine it'd be like spoilers for the movie Watchmen. You remember that scene in Watchmen when the nukes go off and there's that blinding light? Yeah, just imagine like one planet ramming into the other, that blinding light. And as people are screaming and dying, there's one of the planets yells back, "Are you an anesthesiologist? Because I don't feel a thing." Anyways, we're in a bamboo forest now. Always get a bit nervous walking through bamboo forests because of pandas. I know that they're vegetarian, I believe. Herbivores. They only eat bamboo, but that's why you gotta be worried. Just kind of like how a shark will think a surfer is a seal because they look like one from underneath. Pandas mistaken upright humans for bamboo and sometimes attack. So Cheshire tells you, if you're ever going through a bamboo forest, go on all fours. Unless it's panda mating season. Do you know there's such a thing as panda porn? A apparently, like, pandas, since most are raised in captivity, they don't know how to have sex. So basically, like, the zookeepers and the panda keepers have to show them porno videos of pandas getting it on so that they know how to do it. Anyways, that brings me to my next topic. A lot of you, since this is one of my first videos, a lot of you are probably wondering, Cheshire, what sets you apart from other YouTubers? Well, as you know, I, as a puzzler, I revere Lord Layton, and as he is a gentleman, I have a jar on my desk that says, Professor Layton is disappointed with your ungentlemanly behavior, and I put a quarter in the jar every time I do something ungentlemanly, which I will do now, seeing as how I said porn several times. Yeah, come on. There we go. See, this is one of the reasons I like, really love this game. It inspires awe. I mean, look at that. Oh, I'm falling. Speaking of pandas, this is just like that time at the zoo. Okay, I probably already said it before, but this is my second time playing through. Oh, and I'm falling again. And thankfully I'm wearing my portal fall boots. Anyways, I've already played through this, so I have a vague idea how to solve most of these puzzles, so it'll be mostly a walkthrough. And I think this is one of those dealies where you have to go backwards to move forwards. Okay, let's see what's down here. Indeed it is. Okay, now we go back up the stairs. And I should mention that one of the reasons I really like this game is it reminds me of some of my other favorite puzzle games, kind of like The Witness and Awkward Chambers. Awkward Chambers in particular, as you'll see in a minute here. Okay, so this shows the final game mechanics. So just like in Awkward Chambers, you can a lot of puzzles revolve around making these blocks. Okay. And then one of my favorite skills in this game, I can cut. Nothing makes me feel like Zoro from One Piece more than launching these little hockey slashes. Am I pronouncing that right? I know it's spelled H-A-K-I. Hockey. Anyways, I'm cutting. Okay, now for the push tool. Push it. Fuzuro. Da! Okay, then we can Mr. Clean this. I really like that crunchy noise that makes. It's kind of like the sound that you hear when you bite into a bowling pin. Okay, I promised people that we're almost done with the tutorial here. Okay, then with this, I believe we make our way out to the surface of the light world. You'd think that this planet could install some escalators. Oh, jeez. Yeah, I remember that weirded me out when I first played as well. Big old eye looking down at you. As you can see, this is the surface of the light planet. Not much yet, and that hole disappeared. Someone must have applied some preparation H. Okay, so this is our first look at some of the puzzles this game has. We gotta activate these monoliths here. Or are they obelisk spires? I don't know the terminology for freestanding structures like these. Monuments? The structures that look like peeners. Not putting a quarter in the jar for saying peeners. I think Lord Layton would approve. Okay, so on to the next one. Okay, thankfully, like, in our world, most problems here can be solved by either inserting, pushing, or cutting. Okay, then on to the final one. Looks like this one will be doing a little bit of weed whacking. Oh yeah. 3 points. Okay, and one more. Okay, got it. I think that's the last one. Then monoliths activated. Speaking of weed, that eye's getting a bit dilated. Does marijuana cause eye dilation? I forget. I've never partaken of the devil's lawn clippings. The motion of my return is inevitable. It does not rely on X. Yet I have grown impatient. Fulfill your role, messenger, and may two soon be reunited. Okay, I know I've already said this, but text that to your ex. May the two soon be reunited. See what happens. Okay. Then with this, it shows us the collectibles that we're gonna need. And as you notice, the landscape has drastically changed. And I'll be sure to give you all a good look at the start of the next video. Okay, with that, I think we can sum up this video here. And a tradition I'm going to try to start with my videos that have series of episodes. I'll put a riddle at the end of each episode. I mean, at the end of this episode. And as a Sphinx, you know I love riddles. This is one I actually wrote myself. Very proud of it. We rise, fall, and rise again. From within our sheltered den. We carry trophies. A crown and plaque. The hounds are near the front. The sages are in the back. If you guys have the answer to that riddle, or if you have a riddle that you want to challenge me with, feel free to put it down in the comments. And again, thanks so much for watching, and remember, enjoy your mind while you still have one.